Hi, Michelle Seitz here. You're watching Word 2011 for Mac, Hyperlinks. If you have some text to which you would like to add a hyperlink in another section of your paper or report, watch these steps to learn how. To insert a hyperlink in this scenario, first you need to create a bookmark to which you would like to link the hyperlink. Watch the bookmarks video to learn how to create a bookmark. Now, highlight the word or words for which you would like to add a hyperlink. I will highlight the words, change of corporate name. Now either right-click and select hyperlink, or go to the Insert tab and select hyperlink. The Insert Hyperlink dialog box is displayed. In the middle of the dialog box are three buttons: web page, document, and email address. Since I had change of corporate name highlighted, it was automatically populated in the display field. When the document button is selected, you can either click the select button and select a file to link to, or in the link to field, you can enter a path to the file. Or you can click on the locate button in the anchor field and select either heading or bookmarks. When you have bookmarks in a document, an arrow will be displayed next to the bookmark text. Click on the arrow and the bookmarks in this document will be displayed. Select a bookmark and then click the OK button. And click OK again. The hyperlink is now added to your document, and depending on the characteristics of the hyperlink style, will determine how the hyperlink is displayed in your document. My hyperlink style is blue text and underline. You can change the characteristics by going to the menu bar on the Format tab and select Style, and then select the hyperlink style and click Modify. Let's go back into the Insert Hyperlink dialog box, and I'll show you some of the other buttons. When the web page button is selected, you have different options below the button. The text for web page tells you to enter a URL address in the link to field. When you add a URL, it is automatically populated in the display field as well. You can change the text in the display field to whatever text you want to display in your document. After you enter a link, the OK button is active. When the email address button is selected, the screen will change again. This time, it reveals a button called Launch Email Application, which will launch your email program. But you don't have to select it. Instead, you can enter an email address in the To field. If you have already entered email addresses in the dialog box, the Recent Addresses button will be active and you can select one of them. When you enter an address in this field, the Link To and Display fields will also be populated and the OK button will become active. You can enter a subject in the Subject field, such as I have here. Remember that whatever text is in the display field will be added to the body of your document. So you can change the display field to reveal whatever text you want displayed. You can also add a screen tip so that when your readers hover over the hyperlink, it will display whatever text you enter in the screen tip field. Now when I hover over the hyperlink, the mouse button changes, and if you have a screen tip, it will be displayed. Now when you click on the hyperlink, you will be taken directly to that location. And that is the end of this lesson, Hyperlinks.